many of the couples, they just don't want to conceive immediately after their marriage. A sperm that goes inside the uterus, the uterine cavity, it stays there, it is alive there for 5 days. How to attain pregnancy? It is a big question and it's a million-dollar question for all the couples, because they want the stock to visit them as soon as fast as possible. But this doesn't hold true for all the couples. Many of the couples, they just don't want to conceive immediately after their marriage. So first and foremost, couples should have a preconceptional counseling where they should undergo a fertility scoring for themselves, and they should have a medical fitness, and plus they should have a genetic test also to see whether the fetus they are going to carry is going to be perfectly normal or not. Secondly, now let's talk about couples who are trying for pregnancy. So the couples who are trying for pregnancy, basically what is the best time to stay together? The best time to stay together for these couples, for them, is to calculate first and foremost the menstrual cycle of the female partner. For doing this, the female partner, whenever she has got bleeding during her menstrual cycle, the first day when she has got the bleeding is calculated as the first day of the menstrual cycle. This is very important to calculate your fertile period. And the female partner basically ovulates in the mid-cycle. So if you have a pretty regular cycle, say around 28 to 30 days of cycle, you will be ovulating most probably on the 14th day of your menstruation. It's so regular as that. So just to say a time frame, so we give you around 12 to 16 days of the period, like it's your best time together. And the couple should try to stay together with the male partner so that they have, when they give a history, when like they have not been able to conceive, then they go to a doctor and then they say, look, I have not been able to conceive since the past 1 year. But the truth is that the couple has never stayed together actively during the past 1 year with the husband during this active fertile period. And for all those females who are having irregular cycles, but irregular also cycles in which they can predict the cycle. So like in those females who have got a pretty long cycle, maybe you can say 35 days. So in those females also, they can calculate by adding those extra days. Like on 12, you add 5 days. So they will most probably be ovulating on the 17th day of the cycle. But all those females who have having very irregular cycles, in those who cannot predict, we also cannot predict the ovulation in these cycles. Means on those females, in some cycles they are having cycles in 30 days, in some cycle they are having it for 40 days, 50 days. So in these females, it's a pretty irregular cycle and you cannot predict ovulation. To have an exact score of your ovulation, you need to see a gynecologist, because then we will be doing the follicle monitoring on you and we can tell you when the egg has matured, when it is going to rupture, and so that you can stay together with your husband. So these are some of the precautions, or you can say these are some of the guidelines that you need to follow, and you need to know your fertile period. That is very essential for all the couples who are trying pregnancy. Thirdly, there is no such protocol that they have to lie down after they are staying with their husband together, because the sperm that has gone inside your vagina, it's pretty fine that if it's going a small quantity also, because only you need healthy sperm to fertilize the ova. Secondly, a sperm that goes inside the uterus, the uterine cavity, it stays there, it is alive there for 5 days. So if the husband is not available during that time, so you just need not to trigger your buttons and think that, okay, this cycle is lost. So if you're pretty maintaining a natural physical intercourse with your husband, and during the fertile period, if you're not able to stay on that day also, then if you have had a sex together, maybe one day prior, or then also it is okay. Because the egg, it usually stays inside you only for 12 to 24 hours. So that is very essential that prior to the ovulation, you should have had stayed with your husband together. So if you're staying after that, it's not as helpful as if you're staying before that.